कंपनी और अ बिग एस कंपनी और अ बिग कंपनी बिग एस बीट यू वर्क फॉर। हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लाइफ टू टेल अ टेल। फिर भूल गई मेरा नाम बोलना था मुझे, मैं वही भूल जाती हूँ, मेरा नाम बोलना है। आप सबका मेरे चैनल पर स्वागत है। सबसे पहले आई एम सो हैप्पी कि यू गाइस आर फाइंडिंग माय वीडियोस हेल्पफुल। द होल आइडिया, द होल इंटेंशन वाज टू मेक वैल्यूएबल इंफॉर्मेशन अवेलेबल। मेनी ऑफ यू हैव बीन सो स्वीट फॉर कमिंग अप एंड कॉन्टेक्टिंग मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम जस्ट टू इवन गिव मी अ वर्ड ऑफ अप्रिसिएशन। थैंक यू सो 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 मच फॉर दैट, इट रियली मीन्स अ लॉट। But before I start today's video, I just want to reiterate something. You guys are more than welcome to come and say a hi to me on Instagram and have a chat with me. But if you guys have any major questions, please, please, please drop it in the comment section below. Your comments and my answers can be useful to a lot of other people who have similar questions. And you also never know if your question has a different point of view that somebody else might want to answer. So please comment in the comment section with major questions that you have. Otherwise, we can chit chat on Instagram. Okay, so let's get straight into the video. I'll give you a quick recap of part 1 and part 2 if you're new here. So in part 1, we talked about all the eligibility criteria that somebody has to meet to be able to apply to the universities abroad. I'm going to leave the link here, so please click on that to watch part 1. In part 2, we talked about accommodations, rent, cost of living, expenses, everything that you possibly might have to spend after you move to another country, specifically Ireland. We also talked about ROI, which is bahut sara, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to leave the link of part 2 here too, so please watch it if you haven't yet. Anything that includes costs and links, I'm going to drop it in the description below, so do make sure you go through the description before you leave this page. For today's video, we are going to talk about, the first one is going to be what all you need to prepare and invest time on when you're applying to colleges, what all the documents you need to prepare, and the second one is going to be what do you have to do once you get your offer letter in hand, like how do you have to pay the partial fees, full fees, what do you do and how it works and stuff like that. The third one is going to be, how do you apply for the visa? What are the documents that you need when you're applying for visa? Does it get rejected? If it gets rejected, why does it get rejected? And stuff like that. And the fourth one is, how much time does all this take? How much time frame can you allot for each of this aspect? So in the first video, we talked about what all you need to do, how do you shortlist before you apply for a college. So now that you've chosen your course and college, apart from having your IELTS examination test done, apart from having your work experience and apart from having your grades of bachelor's, you also need to have certain Word documents that play a very, very crucial role. When you are applying to a particular university, they are going to read these documents to understand why do you aim to study with them, why do you aim to do this particular course, what is your ambition and things like that. So these documents are also called as application essay, or they are in general terms are called statement of purpose. As the name suggests, statement of purpose is you describing the purpose of why you're trying to do all this. So it is supposed to be a big essay all about yourself. Imagine you're writing an essay about yourself. And another document that you need is a LOR, that is letter of recommendation. So every institution you've been to, from school to high school, then graduation, you have to find somebody like your favorite teacher or your principal or anybody to write a recommendation letter for you. That is going to state that that particular teacher or the principal is recommending your foreign university to consider you, since you have been very good with these people for as long as you lasted with them. These two documents are very, very important. If you guys want me to make a detailed video on how should these documents be curated, how long should you invest in these, I can share a few links of samples as well. So if you guys want me to do that video for you all, then please, please drop a comment in the comment section below. For now, I'm not including it in the series, but I will make it if you guys want me to. Now let's talk about the process of visa application. You have to apply for your visa as soon as you get your offer letter in hand. Usually a few universities send you a conditional offer letter. These are the universities that are trying to find out if you are sure about getting an admission with them or if you are considering other universities too. So as soon as you get a conditional offer letter, and if that is the university you want to be with, then immediately the first step you have to do is send them a confirmation in the form of paying your fees partially. And that's when you get handed over the unconditional offer letter that can be used to apply for your visa. The conditional offer letter doesn't work when you want to apply for your visa. Only the unconditional offer letter does. Now we will talk about the elephant in the room. So how do you apply for the visa? Tuition fee is the most important element for the application of a visa. These guys are trying to understand if you or your family is capable to support you financially for as long as the course lasts. So they want to know if your documents are going to be a proof of the fact that you will be able to sponsor your education, your cost of living, all the expenses for as long as the course lasts. You can usually arrange money from two sources, right? One is your personal savings and the other is taking a loan from the bank. So if you are using your personal savings or personal money that is coming from sources like your property or gold or just savings from years together, everything needs to be on paper. For example, if your university fees is 1050, and if 1000 is from your saving and 50 you're borrowing from the gold you've saved up and stuff like that, even that has to be put on paper. Every small and big figure, when it's on paper, that's when it doesn't seem wrong and you reduce your chances of getting your visa rejected. On the other hand, talking about loans, you can go and borrow loans, educational loans from banks. Make sure that you're finding a bank that's offering you less rate of interest. If you're finding a difficulty in getting a loan from the bank, then there are always third-party credit institutions that will give you a loan easily, but they're slightly going to charge you higher rate of interest. There are certain options that might seem very comfortable and convenient in the beginning, but be very careful because they might take away a lot of money from you that other sources might not. So make a wise choice there. Do your own part of research. Watch videos like these. Talk to people, your friends who have already been through this procedure and who are already settled abroad. Talk to a lot of people. Know what is the best option. Talk to your family. Know what they want to do for you and how they want to do it for you. This is all planning. Sit and plan. Give it a lot of time. Work on it and then make the right decision. Once all your planning is done of how you're going to sponsor your education, there are certain documents that you cannot miss when you're applying for your visa. First one is writing a cover letter to the embassy. You are going to write a letter to the embassy telling them why you're applying to the college, if you got the admission, when did you apply, what course you did, what you studied. It is going to include all the information. Just like you are writing your statement of purpose to the university, the same way you're writing your cover letter to the embassy, you are assuring them that there are certain rules and regulations that a particular student has to follow when they go to another country. Immediate example I'll give you of Ireland. The students are not allowed to work for more than 20 hours a week if they are on a student visa and are attending college on a regular basis. So you have to adhere to this policy. So you're writing in your cover letter that you are going to adhere to all such policies that are supposed to be implied by a student when they go to another country. So that's the whole meaning of a cover letter. The next document that you cannot miss is all the stuff that you have ever accumulated from your educational institutions, from your school to high school to your graduation. Every institution must have given you a mark sheet when you were leaving them, so you have to include your mark sheets in this set of documents. Next is documents from your work experience, be it you worked for a small company or a big company. Everybody gives you a joining letter and everybody gives you a leaving letter. Make sure you include all those documents too. Just in case you have skipped a year of working or of studying, if you have just taken a gap or you were preparing for some exam, make sure you mention these dates and the reason in the cover letter that you were preparing. It's just you're letting people know that this is the time frame where you weren't working or you weren't studying or you were doing something else. And let me tell you one thing, सिर्फ इंडिया में ऐसा होता है जहाँ पे एक साल गैप लेना या फिर कुछ 6 महीने गैप लेना इज अ बैड थिंग. बाहर ऐसा इट डजंट वर्क लाइक दैट आउटसाइड. इट्स ओके टू टेक अ ईयर्स ब्रेक इफ यू आर वॉन्टिंग टू एक्सप्लोर समथिंग एल्स और जस्ट नॉट वॉन्टिंग टू डू एनीथिंग फॉर अ वाइल. इट्स ओके, जस्ट राइट इट एज इज. नोबडी इज गोइंग टू जज यू फॉर दिस. The next document is your passport and your PCC, that's called Police Clearance Certificate. Police Clearance Certificate is a certificate that is issued by the passport office saying that you do not have any charges on yourself. You want people to know that you have not committed any sort of a crime. So this is the certificate that is a proof to that. You can book an appointment to get your PCC from the nearest passport office and you will get it within a day. It's not a big deal. Next is the documents that are going to serve as a proof that you have gotten an admission from a university abroad. So you have to give them the unconditional offer letter that you received from the university. That's the first one. Then you have to show them the receipt of you making them a portion of the payment of the tuition fee. Like if you have paid 50% of the tuition fee, then you will get a receipt from the university, from the admissions department. You have to take a printout of that particular email and show it and include it in your documents. Few universities include the medical insurance within the fees amount, but a few don't. But if you don't, you will have to buy your medical insurance on your own. It will cost you somewhere between 200 to 400 euros. The next and the most important set of documents I'm going to talk about, and ye main move nahi aise main nahi bol paungi, to mujhe dekhkar bolna padega. The financials. This is the financial set of documents. This includes everything from bank statements, income tax returns, fixed deposit, loans, properties, and gold documents if you've used any. Any piece of paper that you think supports and strengthens your application of the visa, just give it. Get everything notarized / attested. This means that you're going to a CA and getting a valuation certificate stating that you have strong ties in India. As a student that you're going to Ireland, you do not plan to live there forever. At least for the sake of having so many strong ties in India, you're going to come back someday. Every student visa works like this. You have to assure them that you are going to come back to your country someday. So the last but not the least is called the visa application summary form. Everything that we have talked about till now, all of these documents are going to be summarized in a form that you're going to download from the Irish embassy. It's a form that is going to make you write all the details that you were talking about till now in them again. And then this is going to be submitted to the VFS. While submitting this, you are going to pay the VFS, that's the visa company through which you are applying to the Irish embassy, a fees which is 6,700. I'm going to leave the link of all this in the description below. Don't forget to go through them at least once. If you think that I've gone wrong somewhere or if you haven't understood anything that I've said, you'll get all the information in detail in the links below. So every country has their own version of a passport size photo. For example, Irish passport size photos version has a different dimension altogether. So usually a visa office that you're going to apply your visa to has a photography section where you go and tell them the name of the country, they'll click your photo and make it of that dimension and give you a set of them. So you're sorted that way. But I'm just mentioning because it is important. When you get there, you shouldn't be like, mere paas passport size photo hai, and then they'll be like, no. You have to go and get yourself clicked once again. So if you want to get dressed properly, then do. The visa is going to take its own sweet time to get to you. I am so tempted to tell you my story at the moment. Every time I have narrated my story to somebody, I've been like, beat that. So it is very adventurous. Anyways, I'm digressing again. So the visa is going to take its own sweet time. There are going to be chances that it gets rejected, but that's the whole point of you being so prepared so that you apply for your visa much ahead of time, so that if it gets rejected, you can apply for it all over again. Once you get your visa, until and unless you don't get your visa and your passport stamped in your hand, do not book your flights and do not book your accommodation, because it can be a total waste of money. You never know what happens. God forbid that it gets rejected. then all your money is going to go down the drain. So don't make that mistake. Even when you're applying for the visa, in their guidelines they say that, you know, you're not supposed to book your tickets until unless you have it in hand. So this is a tip, do not make that mistake. Just in case your visa gets rejected, the rejection packet comes with a letter in which there is a detailed information of why exactly did it get rejected. For example, if there is a document that you forgot to include, they are going to mention that this particular document wasn't there in it. That is why. So if there are a set of documents that you have missed, if there are 4 or 5 documents that you forgot to put in your chunk, then they are going to mention each of them. So what happens is, the next time you're applying for it, you can tick them off your list. For as long as you haven't heard back from your visa guys, the first time or the second time, you can always, they will give you a tracking number. You can go to their website, keep tracking. But out of personal experience, you call them, you email them, you message them, you do anything, they are not going to respond to you. But it's always there. Sometimes if you get lucky, you might get responded to. But I wasn't. So, that is all for today, guys. I tried to not overload you with information. There is a lot of technical stuff that I could have talked about, but I want to keep this as simple as possible. But saying that, I do not want you to go away too far from real information, which is exactly why I'm going to leave all the links in the description below. Please go down, please open each link, read as much as you can, do your share of research. People who are coming in for this intake, I hope the next video is going to be very, very helpful to you guys, because I'm going to talk about all the do's and don'ts of packing. Kya kya pack karna hai? Ye sabse zyada important question hai. I ended up paying, God, I don't want to tell my story. But I can tell this, I think. I ended up paying 25,000 rupees extra for extra baggage, and it was of no good. No good. So, this happened because I had nobody to tell me what to take and what not to. General knowledge, common sense, jitna bhi ho, you always tend to overpack. Kya zarurat hai, kya nahi, ye kisi ka batana bahut zyada zaruri hai. And the next video is going to be all about that. So stay tuned. Until next time, see you. Bye bye. Oh, don't forget to subscribe. Kitne log subscribe nahi kar rahe. If this information is useful, please, please subscribe to my channel. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. Don't forget to hit on the bell icon to get a notification every time I post a new video. Until next time, bye bye. They're pushing me to talk it out, but my heart can hardly. Anything you've achieved? No? ये तो बोला ही नहीं शुरू में कि एक cover letter भी लिखते हैं. मैंने तो 350 दिया. परसों दिया ना 350. This is not a mic. This is a clipper.